Hello, this is Kevin Bacon again. Today I have an entirely different kind of a project than I've done lately. I'm going to fire up the forge. I have a son in Berkeley University in California who needs a tool, and I'm going to try to fashion him one here on the forge and anvil, and with some hammers and some steel and files and knife blades and all kinds of stuff until I come up with something that will perform the task that he has at hand. Anyway, what I have in front of me right here is my regular forge that I built in one of my videos earlier, and I've made an enclosure out of firebrick so it will concentrate the heat over a larger area, because I'm going to work with a longer piece than I normally would if I was working with a knife. Then I've left a hole back here so that I can set my fancy sink chimney on top of that to draw the fumes away from my face. And also, any sparks or anything that fly kind of go that direction instead of coming back at me, which is infinitely better in my book. I've got to clean the grate that goes down in the bottom for the airflow and put the blower on it, and cut me up a bunch of hedge, because I'm gonna burn hedge today. Anyway, let's get at it. Well, there's a hunk of hedge. That thing probably weighs 20 pounds. It's amazingly heavy stuff. It just barely floats. And it's dense, but it's splintery, nasty stuff. If you've never had the pleasure of burning this stuff, though, you're really missing something, because it burns so hot. People burn the chimneys out on their stoves with it. I've gone through, a dozen fire grates in wood stoves, because it just burns them. It just burns them. So that's what we're going to use today, because that's what I have. Well, I got all set up and it started to rain. And man, did it rain. It got what I would have called a cloudburst. Just a really strong inch an hour or faster rain. Didn't last very long, but long enough that I would have been in real trouble if I'd have been started when it started. Hopefully that will hold off. So I threw some papers in the bottom there, and I've got some cedar board on top of that to get a start here. I fired up the blower just to give it a little bit of extra oomph to get her started. And we'll be bending some steel here pretty quick. Okay. I got some fire going there. I'm pulling the basic temper out of a file. I'll try to explain what I'm making if I can. It's called a bearing scraper, and the best description I was given is that it's like a straight razor, in that it's curved with an edge at the curve, so you can control the curve very well. And bent in such a way that you can manipulate it. When they used to scrape Babbitt bearings, they poured a harder form of lead into a bearing block and then scraped it with one of these scrapers to get the tolerances that they wanted at the other end. And so I took a piece of mild steel, and I gave it a bit of a practice here, putting a curve in it. And now I'm gonna roast that file and work it down until I get the curve I want out of it. I'm using a ball peen hammer, not my favorite hammer, but in this case, it's what functions the best. Starting to get some red off of that file I can see in there. And what I have in there, this piece over here on this side, is a piece of hackberry, which is still kind of a soft hardwood, like box elder or soft maple or something like that. It's real stringy, it's not good for much. And then the rest of it is my buddy hedge, and it makes a unbelievably hot fire for a fresh wood, as I said earlier. So I'm just slowly working these pieces of hedge down into the fire pot and working on pulling that out. If I get something better, I'll show you some. Now, I don't know if the color of that file is going to show up in there or not, but the end of it's critical already. So didn't take very long. That hedge is mean. I need to get that critical about 3/4 of the way down that blade of the file so that when I work with it, I don't break it. So I hope it'll pick that color up down in there. I'm going to pull that baby out a little ways there. It's a bright orange. Got a little ways further to go. I may have to turn it around and send it in backwards. I really don't want to if I don't have to. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take my cross peen and I'm just going to kind of lay these file teeth over for about 4 inches because I got to put a handle on the end where it can be drawn. It is unbelievably soft. All right, I want to bend this up at about 4 inches. And he said about a 30-degree angle. It's kind of awkward because I'm trying to work inside of the camera. I think I'll move the camera. Okay, now they're hot again. Right, I'm going to shove in the Pritchell hole right here just to make a real quick poker for the stove. There, just that fast. Now I can move my wood around. Okay, she's a hot one. Lay her right in there like that. Right smack in the middle. Start to form that. If you want to see a real blacksmith, you got to go see Gary Houston, because he's a real blacksmith. My brother doesn't do YouTube videos that I know of. He's a real blacksmith. Me, I'm just a getting started, but gave me an idea, so. Oh, I have. I have a regular pair of blacksmith tongs, but I don't know where they are right at the moment, and this is kind of a hasty job.
Okay, I got it really hot that time.
As I put this curve into this file, the file wants to change its flat, so I have to straighten it out as I go along here. Oh yeah, we're getting a good curve in there. I'm going to go about another 3 inches. Then we'll start the grinding process probably. I let that last one go a lot longer than I wanted to. I hope I can edit it down. If not, I'm going to lose the clip. Okay, bright red again. And this is where I want to end the curve. I'm going to put some finish up on it here. When it's hot. Oh my. That's great. Okay, now this edge over here needs to have it a bevel on it. It's going to be sharper. So we're going to bevel this edge. And we're going to take the tools off the forge table because they're getting hot. Okay, a little more bevel work. This time we're going to get out the big one. Hard to lift, but it really does the job. Hello, this is Kevin Bacon again. Second day, firing up the forge, getting ready to put the hardness back in this tool. It turns out I had bent it the wrong direction on the end, so I re-bent that last night. My son watched the video and gave me some better instructions. It's a scraper, not a slicer, so the edge will be different than I had anticipated. And now, what I need to do is get this forge fired up so that I can put the hardness back in it. To give you a little side view of the forge here, underneath we have our clear air goes across over there. I've got a big dump down under here for excess air. It's wide open because I didn't need that much air. This is an oyster. Hair dryer with the heating element removed, and half of the intake vents are plugged off because otherwise it's still pushing too much air. And then it seems to work just about perfect. So this particular Ford shows up in an earlier video. I'm going to make a much bigger one with a longer firebox, but this is really pretty good for small projects like this. I can heat 5, 6, 7 inches at a time without any problem. Much bigger than that project, I'm not ready for at this moment anyway. Okay, I want to show you a couple tips that I get as I go along here. The piece of steel on the top there, it's just mild steel, is there to get hot, to throw in the oil bath, to bring the oil temperature up so that it's not just ice cold. It seems to be better 100, 120 degrees for a temperature to work with. So I've learned to heat a piece of steel. I was told heat a rod, but I don't have a piece of bar stock right now. That'll have to do. When that gets up fiery hot red, I'll just throw it over here in the oil to bring the oil temperature up before I dip this file. Okay, my tie-down strap in there, piece of mild steel, is starting to glow some pretty good red, so I'm going to throw it in the oil and let it put the preheat on the oil. I hope you can see that glow. It's pretty remarkable. To the bottom and let her cook while I get this other up to critical. Yeah, I bricked that forge in a little bit more to concentrate the heat where I want it. And I only want to heat about the middle 7 or 8 inches of that up to critical, because that's where the actual cutting edge is. The rest of it is just handles. There's no use having the handles too hard. Got a nice bright red going on that file. I'm going to test it on my magnet. It does not stick. So into the fire and into the oil it goes. That's a magnet, ceramic magnet off the back of a speaker. I keep it stuck to my forge all the time just for these uses. Anyway, while that's getting its cool down going on, I'll get this fire put to sleep. Okay, proof of hardness. File just skates right across. Cleans off the scale, but it won't touch the steel. So that's where I want it. Now to finish grind it and sharpen it up and get it ready for the mail. Hey, I'll show you real quickly how I put this fire out. I just put these fire bricks right over top of it and it snuffs it right out. Just there. Now in a few minutes that'll be pretty well out and there'll be coals for another fire. I'll rearrange the bricks as it cools down a little and get them to shut the air off better. Okay, Kevin had some question as to how durable the edge on this would be. And although I don't have the finish put on it, I'd just like to give you a little show. This is galvanized steel. We'll call it mild steel. I'm sure it's not any better than mild steel, but we know that it is a lot tougher than zinc. And I'm just gonna peel some. Off here. And there are little files, like little squiggly skews, all over there. And there are some hanging on the file, but the edge remains just as sharp as it did before I started. So I think this ought to work. If you can manage my crude shape, it ought to cut just about anything that's cuttable without much damage. Can be easily sharpened. Well, as easily as this can be sharpened, with a flat stone right along the edge. And that'll bring this right up back to like it is basically a razor. I put a little notch right there. A little notch right there to give you an idea of where the ends of the cutting zone were. If you get a burr on the inside, you can just carefully remove the burr like that, and we're back into full cutting force. So now I'm going to take it back down into my basement onto my precision grinders and continue to make it look pretty. But beyond that, I'd say that's another one in the can. Kevin Bacon. Bye.